One thing that's extremely important when you're operating as a professional remote pilot is documentation. Now, I know it's not the most exciting of subjects, but it is one of the most important. Every time that you operate, you need to have access to these four things: your remote pilot certificate, the individual registration for each of the aircraft that you'll be using, any airspace authorization or waiver that you're operating under, and the maintenance records for the aircraft that you'll be using. So let's go through these one by one, starting with your Airman certificate. After you pass your Part 107 written exam with flying colors using onlinegroundschool.com, you're going to get a hard copy Airman certificate that looks like this. Now, you want to make sure you have this on your person or within easy access every time that you fly. But keep in mind that this does not have a photo on it, so there's no way for someone to be able to tell that you are who you say you are. So you want to make sure you have a photo ID on you as well. Now, if you're operating under a waiver or airspace authorization, you want to make sure that you make available those documents as well. So have those ready. Now let's go on to what you need for the aircraft. You need to make sure that you have detailed records of any repair, modification, overhaul, or replacement of a system component resulting from normal flight operations, and recording the time in service for that component at the time of the maintenance procedure. Now, this is not just me giving you good operational advice. This is straight from the FAA. They go on to say, over time, the operator should then be able to establish a reliable maintenance schedule for the SUAS and its components. This is why it's so important to keep a good logbook, to keep a detailed account of all of the time and workload that you put on every single component of the aircraft. If your manufacturer doesn't supply you with a maintenance schedule, it's important to take the time to really come up with a good one yourself. That way, if you ever need to prove safe flying practices, you have a detailed account of every single thing that you've done with that aircraft. Now, you can do this either on paper or electronically, but whichever one you choose, just make sure that you have a good backup in case you lose one or the other. Let's move on to registration. The FAA says that the individual registration number for each aircraft has to be on the aircraft by either permanent marker, engraving, or a label, and it has to be visibly readable and accessible upon inspection. It can also be somewhere inside the aircraft, like the battery compartment. Now, the actual registration for the aircraft does have to be on your person every time that you fly, but it does not have to be in a printout format. You can have it electronically, like on your phone, iPad, or computer. You just have to make sure that it's readily accessible and available upon request for any local, state, or federal law enforcement. For the links to the FAA resources, we've provided those in the library at onlinegroundschool.com. Thanks for watching, guys. Like and subscribe for more awesome content. Good flying.